Hello everyone, this is Marika Lamoureux, and this will be a short explanation of understanding when variables are fully and partially crossed. So if you are thinking, what is this whole crossing thing? I have no idea what's going on. Have no fear, this video will explain it. When you're talking about crossing, you are talking about whether all possible combinations of all the levels of your independent variable are combined or are present in your study. So let's imagine that we are going to do a study and we're going to look at where people live, if they live in Europe or America, and whether they are in high school or college influence their knowledge of current world events. And we can talk about whether these two independent variables are fully or partially crossed. And our first independent variable is where they live, Europe or America. And our second independent variable is whether they're in high school or college. So if they are fully crossed, you can see that there are all four levels, or both levels of both independent variables are present in the study. So you have high school kids who live in Europe, high school kids who live in America, college kids who live in Europe, and college kids who live in America. And if you look over and you can see that for partial crossing, it means one of the combinations is missing. So for a partial crossing, in this example, you don't have high school students who live in Europe. So it's really very simple. Is it, do you have all the combinations of all of your independent variables or not? So now we're going to go ahead and work through some examples. So go ahead and pause this video, and when you think you know the answer, unpause it. This is partially crossed because you are missing the combination of shoe and medium. So unpause the video when you think you have this. This is fully crossed because you have every combination of each level of both independent variables. Unpause the video when you think you have this. So this is fully crossed because you have all the combinations of all the independent variables. You have people who got a full sleep and who had breakfast, people who had partial sleep and who had breakfast, people who had full sleep and no breakfast, and people who had partial sleep and no breakfast. So unpause the video when you think you're ready. This is partially crossed because you are missing two of those combinations. And that's it. That's how you determine whether something is fully or partially crossed. Just make yourself that little chart, put the X's in the boxes of the things that have the combinations, and if there are any boxes that don't have X's, you know it's partially crossed.